And maybe that's because I lost him so early on in our marriage. But when Lee proposed, I was ready to move on. I was even gonna stop wearing our wedding band around my neck. I was really ready to put Stefan behind me.
Easier to do when he's dead.
Exactly. How can I do that when he's right here? Even if he says he doesn't love me, what? Do I just give up? I can't just give up, right?
It doesn't sound to me like Stefan's leaving much of a choice.
Rolf had you on ice. He never said a word.
I guess he figured there wasn't any point. Couldn't wake me up until he found a heart.
Why? You did just fine without one before.
Clever. Look, Chad, I know you and I have had our differences.
So differences? Do I have to remind you what you did to my wife?
But I'm hoping that this could be a new beginning for us.
No, thank you.
All right, look, I don't expect you and Abigail to welcome me back with open arms.
She's dead.
What?
It's true.
Abigail's dead? What happened?
She was murdered.
I appreciate you trying to lift my spirits. I do. And I want to enjoy doing things like this with you. But when it's something that I remember doing so well with her, with Abigail.
I get it. Believe me, I get it.
It's supposed to get easier with time, I know. But for me, every day that goes by, I just miss her more, not less.
Me too. I'll tell you what. Satan, the next time we have ice cream Sunday night, we recruit Thomas and Charlotte. And we share with them all the wonderful, fun memories that we have of our mom when she was a little girl. What do you think? Would that make it easier for you?
Yeah, it would. Yeah, because that would be good for the kids, you know? For us to share our memories of her with them and them to share some of their memories with us. Right? I mean, we should encourage
them. We should.
That's what Abigail would want.
But then that's what we'll do.
Okay. Good. But in the meantime, since you went to all the trouble and, you know, don't want that ice cream to melt, we should make those sundaes now.
You're sure?
Yes, I'm sure. So I think Abigail would want that,
too. Yeah.
I'm thinking Leo hasn't gone after Chloe or Brady because he still cares about me.
Hate to burst your bubble, Greg, but that sounds a tad bit narcissistic to me.
I know that Leo is not happy with what happened at the wedding. But if he ever went near my daughter, touched her.
Have you seen Chloe since you got back in town?
Mm-mm. I came straight here. I was hungry. I wanted to get something to eat. Why don't we all go out and have a bite together? All of us. Celebrate your engagement.
All of us?
Chloe, Brady, you. Both of you. My treat.
Oh, so very kind of you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Craig. You're a real stand-up guy.
Are you nuts? You can't call the police.
Why not? We have to investigate Craig so that they can clear your name.
Are you going to tell them that I'm here? Are you going to turn me in?
Why would I do that?
Because you're probably still mad as hell that I lied and told everyone you confessed.
Yes, well, I'm obviously still miffed about that. But Matthew, I understand why you did what you did.
You explained that you were backed against a wall.
Winnie, I had to get away. I am so sorry that I threw you under the bus.
Okay, all right, yeah, that's all right. Enough with the apologies now. Now, the important thing is that we prove your innocence. Otherwise, you are going to spend the rest of your life on the run.
Okay. Okay, let's bring Dr. Death's pathetic life. Pathetic because I'm no longer in it and he's never going to find anyone else as sexy and adorable as I am. Let's bring that sadistic, twisted, lovesick man's life to a screeching halt.
Yeah, hang on.
What's the matter?
You know, if you two don't mind, I'd really like to share the good news with Chloe by myself.
Sure, you go ahead.
And in the meantime, why don't the two of you get to know each other? I mean, we are going to be family.